My name's Sue Spencer. I'm one of the consultants at QServe. And I'm here today to talk to you about the new MHRA Brexit guidance document that was issued in September 2020. So let's start from the beginning. The UK has left the European Union and is now in a transition period. And that transition period ends at the end of 2020. So MHRA issued guidance about what would happen during this transition period back in January. And basically during the transition period, the UK operates as though they were still part of Europe as it relates to medical devices and IVDs. The market access hasn't changed. It's still CE marking. Firms can continue to use MHRA in the way that they normally would for vigilance and also for clinical investigations and things like that. And the UK still has access to the European data systems like EudaMed that it normally would have access to. The new guidance that has been issued is really looking post the transition period. And so the post the Brexit transition we're talking about here. The new guidance was issued in September 2020. And the changes that it's discussing here apply to England, Scotland and Wales. But Northern Ireland is much more complicated. It has a certain level of duality, which I'll talk about as we go through this presentation. And it is quite complicated, I'm afraid. So MHRA will also continue to be the competent authority. Let's look at the new draft requirements. So starting from the 1st of January 2021, CE marking will continue to be used and recognised, but this will only be until the 30th of June 2023. So certificates issued by European-based notified bodies will continue to be valid, and that's right up until the 30th of June 2023. So in other words, it's an 18-month transition period. A new route to market will be coming into place after that period, and that will be a UK CE mark. However, you will be able to apply that from the 1st of January 2021. So from the 1st of January 2021, all medical devices and IVDs placed on the market in the UK will need to be registered with the MHRA. There will be a grace period though, and that varies depending on the risk category of the device. So the grace period is 4 months for class 3 and 2B implantable devices, and also active implantable medical devices and annex to list A IVDs. It will be 8 months for all the rest of the 2B medical devices and the 2A medical devices, and also the annex to list B IVDs and self-test IVDs. And then finally, it'll be 12 months for the class 1 medical devices and also the general IVDs. So if you are a manufacturer based outside of the UK and you want to sell products within the UK, you're going to need a UK responsible person who will take responsibility for that product in the UK. So registration requirements, as I said, will apply from the 1st of January 2021. Manufacturers based in the UK have to register with MHRA. Manufacturers outside the UK will need a UK responsible person to do this. So the UK responsible person will then assume the responsibilities of the manufacturer in terms of registering the device with MHRA. So manufacturers based outside of the European Economic Area who have an authorised representative that's established in Northern Ireland will not need to designate a UK responsible person when placing a device on the Northern Ireland market. So this is where we start to see this complication, and that Northern Ireland has a bit of a duality at the moment. So the Northern Ireland based authorised representative will be able to register devices with MHRA on behalf of the manufacturer. And don't forget that there will be registration fees that will apply. So the role of the UK responsible person is to ensure that the declaration conformity and also the technical file has been drawn up, and where applicable, that if there's any conformity assessments that have to be done, that those have been conducted by the manufacturer. So in other words, if they need an outside body to come and audit them, that's taken place. So they need to keep available a copy of that technical file and also the declaration of conformity. And if there's any certificates or supplementary certificates that go with that, they will also need to hold copies of those. They'll need to be able to provide MHRA with information and any documentation that they request, and also forward to the manufacturer any requests that the MHRA has to acquire samples from the market or access to the device itself. The UK responsible person will cooperate with the MHRA on any preventive or corrective actions taken to eliminate or, if not possible, mitigate risks from that device, and immediately inform the manufacturer about complaints and reports from healthcare professionals, patients and users about suspected incidents relating to a device for which they have been designated. So if the UK responsible person terminates the legal relationship that they have with the manufacturer, and that's because the manufacturer has been acting contrary to their obligation, then there is a requirement for the UK responsible person to inform MHRA and also the notified body, if it's applicable, of that termination. So MHRA have said that they will issue further guidance on these roles. So another little bit of background. The UK retains legislation that will be on the statute book come the end of the transition period. So don't forget, at the moment we're operating as though we were in Europe, although we're not. The laws that are on the statute book come the 31st of December 2020 will be those that are used moving forwards. Now, we shouldn't forget that the MDR and the IVDR will not actually be on the statute book at that point. So therefore, they won't be automatically retained because they haven't reached their date of application. So the effective legislation moving forwards from the 1st of January 2021 will actually be the Medical Device Directive and the IVD Directive. And there is a medicines and medical device bill that is going through Parliament at the moment, which is correcting dates and things like that. I mentioned earlier on that there will be a UK CA mark. So the UK conformity assessment mark is the new mark, and it is not restricted to just medical devices. So you will see other devices that in the past would have born a CE mark could now bear a UK CA mark. So the UK CA mark will not be recognised in Europe. And part of the reason for that moving forwards is because the legislation will have departed. Europe will have moved on to the regulation, whereas the UK will still be using the directives. And so products currently requiring CE marking will still need a CE mark for sale if you want to sell it in Europe, the European Economic Area, or because Northern Ireland has this duality in Northern Ireland as well. So manufacturers will be able to, but not required to, use the UK CE mark from the 1st of January 2021, but it will be mandatory from the 1st of July 2023. So we've had notified bodies in the past. In the new UK scheme, these conformity assessment bodies will be called approved bodies. So from the 1st of January 2021, the MHRA will be able to designate UK conformity assessment bodies so that they can issue certificates as required for the UK CA mark. The existing UK notified bodies will roll over their existing designations for medical device or IVD or active implantable devices, and they won't have to go through extra designation processes to be able to do that. So UK approved bodies will only be able to conduct conformity assessments for medical devices, active implantables and IVDs according to the UK Medical Device Regulation 2002. And it gets slightly complicating because of the name. So although it's called the Medical Device Regulation, it's not the European Medical Device Regulation. And that regulation covers medical devices, active implantables and IVDs. And that will be in the form that exists from the 1st of January 2021. And as I said before, that will be the directives as it stands at the moment. From the 1st of January 2021, devices will have to bear a valid CE mark or the UK CA mark. So in this period between the 1st of January 2021 and the end of June 2023, devices either have to have a CE mark and a valid CE mark. So obviously once the regulations come in, it would have to be appropriately approved to that, or a UKCA mark. And so that would be to the directives or the text that's within the directives. So the UKCA mark is required from the 1st of July 2023, where it becomes mandatory. So if a notified body was needed in the past, then it will now be a UK approved body to issue this UKCA mark. And if one of those is required, in the same way that for Europe, you will have the notified body number underneath, you'll now have a approved body number underneath the UKCA mark. And if you want to know the size and the shape and how you can use it, there's further guidance that is available on the link that I've just shown below. If we look at post-market surveillance and vigilance, the UK requires that post-market surveillance and vigilance activities continue after the 1st of January 2021. So although we've formally left Europe, and they will be issuing further guidance about how to do this. But in the interim, MHRA points you to their existing guidance document for post-market surveillance and also for vigilance. So in other words, it's a case of using the current systems. Now, I've mentioned before this duality with Northern Ireland. This is formally called the Northern Ireland Protocol and was there to prevent having a hard border, in other words, customs posts between Northern Ireland and the Republic of Ireland. Now, there's obviously other political moves that are going on at the moment in the background. So as that's changing literally on a daily basis, I'm sticking to exactly what's within the MHRA guidance at the moment. So just be aware this will be subject to change. And also MHRA have said that they will issue additional guidance to this. So it is complicated. This is the best understanding I have from reading the guidance. So under the guidance as it stands at the moment is that there will be a requirement to register devices with MHRA if you're selling in Northern Ireland and have a UK responsible person if that manufacturer is based outside of Ireland. So the medical device regulation and the IVD regulation will apply in Northern Ireland from the respective dates in 2021 and 2022 from their appropriate dates of application. So this is where Northern Ireland is acting as though it were in Europe, even though it is part of the United Kingdom. This is what makes it slightly complicated. So another way of looking at this timeline is that we have here the 1st of January 2021, where the UKCA mark comes into existence and we have the new regulatory scheme and it becomes mandatory from the 1st of July 2023. But in that intervening period, you can sell in the UK if you have a valid CE certificate. Depending on where the date of application is, it might be a device or a regulation certificate. There is no need for a label change to add a UKCA mark in this intervening period, but you will need to do the registration, and if needed you'll need to have a UK responsible person, as I said before, with the appropriate grace periods. So Northern Ireland has to consider the date of applications for the MDR and the IVDR in the same way that Europe would have to. And the UKCA mark is not recognised there. So I've tried to summarise here what the legislation would look like from the 1st of July 2023. So if you're wanting to sell in the UK, so if we first of all look at the UKCA mark, currently that is the MDD and the IVDD text, although it would be issuing a UKCA mark, That would give you market access to England, Wales and Scotland. And you would need a UK approved body if it was required. So if you were a high risk medical device or an IVD, you currently have a notified body, you would have to have a UK approved body if you wanted to use the UK CE mark and sell within the United Kingdom. And if you're outside of the UK, then you would need a UK responsible person. So in Europe, or if you're selling to Northern Ireland, you need a CE mark. As it's beyond the 1st of July 2023, then both the medical device and the IVD regulations would apply. You would need notified bodies as applicable, and also you would need either an authorised representative that was based in Europe, or that authorised representative could also be in Northern Ireland. But the authorised rep could not be in England, Wales or Scotland. And then if you were a Northern Irish, you would just want to sell in Northern Ireland alone, you could use a CE UK Northern Ireland mark, which would be kind of similar to the UK CA mark. So you could just sell in Northern Ireland, and the you would need a UK approved body in the same way as you would in the UK. And you would also need to register with MHRA and also have a UK responsible person. So that's our understanding as it is at the moment. The text in the guidance when it comes to Northern Ireland is complicated and it's very difficult to understand. So I would strongly suggest that you read it, and also as the new guidance comes out, that you pay attention and look at that. So finally, Brexit is complex and requirements will evolve over the coming months. At QServe, we're trying to track the requirements and we're putting together services to support you. We know that some manufacturers have said to us that that whilst they may have a distributor in the UK, they would actually really rather have an independent body that understood the regulations to actually represent them in the UK. So we're putting together a service to support those manufacturers. So if you are interested in that, please email info@qservegroup.com. And if you want to know more, follow us on LinkedIn or our website, which is qservegroup.com. So I hope you found this useful. Keep a watch on our website and we will try and keep you up to date as best we can. So thank you very much for your attention.